Hi guys, and welcome to our video series today. In this video series, we're going to give you our top tips on how to improve and how to prepare for your running sessions, whether that's just for training sessions, might be your first half marathon or marathon, or how to just help you get the most out of your body when you're running.
Hi guys, my top tip for running is preparation. So it is really important that you try and improve your nutrition before race day. So 6 to 7 days out, it is really important to try and add some carbohydrates and increasing the amount of carbohydrates to your meals, particularly in the evening, to give yourself a little bit more energy for race day. It's also really important to get in the right mindset. When I start at the beginning of a race, I've already been thinking about what I'm going to do during that race for the last 2 or 3 days, really thinking it's going to be a really successful, positive run, and it really helps me perform well and get the best out of my body. But just remember, running is difficult, it is hard work, and you do have to put the effort in. See you later, guys. Thanks.
Hi, guys. So my top tip for running is to make sure that you warm your legs up properly. So a lot of people, they'll have different types of techniques, different foot placements. A lot of people will run heel toe, a lot of people run midfoot, or they'll go on ball of the foot. If you are doing midfoot or ball of foot striking, you need to make sure that you warm your calves up properly, otherwise you will get aches, pains and strains, which we see a lot of. So you can do certain things at home, like calf raises. You can do those, as Matt is about to demonstrate, you can do it on a step up box if you're going to use a gym. You can do them on your stairs at home. You can just do them on a flat surface. You can do double legged. You can go single leg. As you can see, Matt is doing it nice and slow, which is good for everyday use, just to make sure that your calves are nice and strong. But before you go out for a run, it's good to do them a little bit quicker, just to make sure that you wake them up before you go. Thanks, guys.
Hi guys, so my tip in this video is all around the glutes and how we need to make sure that they're nice and strong and also warmed up before we go out for a run. So what I want to do is use a think of those glutes similar to the rotator cuff of the shoulder, because they're both ball and socket joints, and I'm sure that we've all heard about rotator cuff problems in the past. So what I'm going to get you to do is do a strengthening exercise to really help get those glutes nice and strong so they stabilise you, but also want you to warm them up before you go out for your run to prevent any injury. So the exercise we're going to look at here is something we call a crab walk. So very simply, you just take a band around both sides of your feet and then you do some sideways movements, trying to keep the tension on all the way through that movement. And by doing this, you've got the activation of the right leg as you're moving the foot away, but the left leg is also stabilizing as you then build that tension on the band. And what this really looks at and focuses on is a muscle we call your glute med, which is something we typically find can be quite weak in clinic. So if you can get that working better and get it stronger, it won't tire as you're running and you're less likely to get any injuries. And if you'd like to come into the clinic, get a band or run through the exercise with us, we've got them here, we're more than happy to give you one. Cheers guys.
Hi guys, so my top tip for preparing to run is a movement I always do before I go out for a run. It's a great way to mobilize the spine and the lower back, because there's actually quite a bit of rotation in any running that you do. So the idea is, before you go out, so you're ready to run, part of your warm up should definitely be some cross body kicks. So start off by kicking the legs out quite straight, and after you've done a few reps, try and add a rotation. Okay, so you're going to rotate over the knee, kick out the leg, just going to stretch out the hamstrings and the calf, and the rotation is going to help to free up the hips and the lower back. Okay, so try that out next time you go for a run. Thanks for watching. Catch up soon.